Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here, and in today's GTA 5 video, we're going to be talking about how Rockstar finally acknowledged the purple and green alien gang wars currently happening in Grand Theft Auto Online. It's kind of cool to just hear from them about this viral trend going on, and we'll also get some information on the upcoming 2020 summer DLC update, including when it could be arriving, and some good news surrounding that as well. So let's begin with Rockstar acknowledging the fact that there is a massive purple and green alien gang war going on right now in Grand Theft Auto Online. And on the event week yesterday, they actually gave away the purple Martian bodysuit and the green Martian bodysuit for free, which normally they are like a couple hundred thousand dollars each. So that's actually a pretty big deal. If you were to buy both of them, you'd spend well over $600,000 on them. So the fact that they made this free is literally like giving away a couple of free cars. So it's kind of a big deal. And they also gave away the pool cue as well from the ammunition store, which seems to be the melee weapon of choice for many that want to utilize and partake in this gang war activity. However, on the Newswire page, there was no mention of Rockstar doing this, so it kind of made people wonder if this was just something they were slipping in the background, if they really didn't want to acknowledge it. Well, it turns out today they finally did, and this is hysterical. So they said this on Twitter: green and purple Martian bodysuits are free in GTA Online all week long. Grab yours and join the fight. Available from any clothing store by going to Outfits, Arena War, and Bodysuits. And plus, pick up a pool cue from Ammunition for free until May 13th. So very cool. And they also included this photo as well. I love how they had to describe where to get the bodysuits, because that is one of the more confusing things if you're newer to Grand Theft Auto Online, is how like the clothing store works. Rockstar keep outfits available at like the clerk station up front, and then like regular clothing is scattered throughout the store. It's kind of mismatched, that's for sure. So that's something I actually explained in my very first video about the green and purple Martian bodysuit war, was actually how you could pick it up. But it is cool to see Rockstar actually acknowledging this. And it kind of makes you wonder if they're going to do anything like this in the future, because this has become probably the most popular trend on the internet right now. I was going to say in GTA Online, but certainly it's taken over the entire internet. And I think that Rockstar is going to utilize another opportunity like this to do some sort of fun, free promotion. I don't know. I'll be sure to follow this over the next couple of weeks, but you've got until May 13th, as they said on Twitter, in order to take advantage of this. And do so if you're going to partake in this. It'll save you like $600,000, which is a lot of money, that's for sure. But anyways, let's move on to some information from Rockstar Games insider Tez Funds 2 on the upcoming 2020 summer DLC. He had some interesting things to say on the GTA forum site. He started by saying this: first week of May, and I'm seeing some progress on Steam database. Three updates to the development branch. I guess Rockstar set up meetings in the last few weeks to prepare the developers to kick things off in May, boosting up the production rate, even though there are some obstacles like motion capture, which requires the developers to meet up in the studio. Nonetheless, it's nice to see that the new policy didn't slow them down for long as this pandemic is going on. Okay, so essentially what Tez Funds 2 is monitoring here is a website called the Steam Database page. And this is where we can see Rockstar making changes to developmental branches like QA Beta and whatnot. And we know when certain branches get updated that Rockstar is working and preparing on the next update. And finally, after weeks of nothing, we are starting to see some activity. And he believes that this is good news, is that Rockstar is finally allowing their developers to sort of get things started on the next update. And obviously, due to what's going on right now in the world and the fact that Rockstar and almost everyone is working from home nowadays, they have been slowed down on producing the next update. In fact, some things, like we've even talked about in previous videos, like doing motion capture, are just not possible right now, because it requires like person-to-person interaction. It requires, you know, the opening of businesses that might be considered non-essential. So it just isn't possible for Rockstar to do some things. But the good news is it looks like they are at least getting the ball rolling on starting with the next update. Now, in response to what TezFunds2 said, another user replied saying, "So, you're saying that maybe the motion captures will kick in May and maybe late June we can get the DLC." And he said, "I'm saying development is proceeding at a faster rate. For all I know, it could be bug fixing or anything else. It may not have anything to do with motion capture, so it could remain as an issue." And we'll talk a little bit about that towards the end of this video, bug fixes and whatnot. But bottom line, he says, good news is that development is proceeding at a faster rate than it normally has. Although he does mention that there could still be some issues with motion capture, and that could remain a problem. And the reason that's a problem is the recent GTA Online updates have had cutscenes and new characters, unlike what we saw in the first couple of updates. I mean, the Diamond Casino and Resort had cutscenes and missions and cinematics, and all of that requires motion capture, which again could be a potential issue. And as a follow-up to that, another individual said, "So is this a good sign for a sooner rather than later release date?" And TezFunds2 says, "It depends. Maybe Rockstar found a workaround to deal with the obstacles which lead to the boost in production. This would be a good sign that the new content could be done sooner than later. Or they are prioritizing certain parts of the update, like bug fixing, while looking for a workaround. This would be a good sign for the update quality, but more time would be needed." Okay, so essentially what TezFunds2 is saying here is that Rockstar might be developing this update sort of backwards. So usually Rockstar would prioritize bug fixes for the very end of an update. Once like everything is pretty much set in stone, they're just sort of ironing out some of the details that aren't working so great. Well, it looks like they might be doing this now while they can, because some things might not be available for them to do. Like, for example, motion capture and recording cinematics and stuff like that. And he's saying, as far as the release date goes, this could be a good sign that it will be done sooner rather than later. Now, I'm still predicting that we are probably a month or two away from a new GTA Online update, probably in the month of July, but it wouldn't be shocking if it did come out in June. Rockstar love those 2 months to release DLCs and updates. So we really just will have to wait and see. With all of this in mind, I've really just wanted to hear something from Rockstar. And I know that's not their MO, but it would be nice to get like a news wire that says, "Hey, we're working on the next update. Don't worry. We're in uncertain times right now. We're trying our best, but something's going to be coming real soon." I wish they would have done something like that. Right now, we're just kind of in the dark. We're just getting these random event weeks. Luckily, we've had fun things to tide us over, like the purple and green alien gang wars that are going on, but that's nothing that Rockstar created other than them adding the bodysuits in the game almost 2 years ago. So I am hopeful that we will get something soon, because I know everyone is getting a little bit bored and anxious to see what is coming up next here in Grand Theft Auto Online. And the final thing that we're going to be discussing in this video today, a lot of people were wondering if something new came with the Thursday event week that Rockstar did the other day. Like, for example, on the GTA forum site, someone said, "Was there anything else added with the Cyclone, which, as you guys know, is the current podium vehicle right now?" And Insider TezFunds2 simply said no. So there wasn't anything as far as a background update. And then on Twitter, he actually responded to someone that asked relatively something similar. They asked if like the frozen chips glitch was fixed. And TezFunds2 said, "No new background updates, so no." So that again is something that I will monitor over the next couple of days and weeks. If Rockstar does push out a new background update, I'll be sure to let you know. Likely it would be fixing bugs and glitches and stuff like that. But maybe, just maybe, it'll give us a hint as to what is coming up next. But anyways, that's all the information that I've got for you guys in this video today. Hopefully you did enjoy. I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. What do you think of Rockstar finally publicly acknowledging the green and purple alien gang war in online? And what do you think it means that Rockstar is starting to work on the next update? Let me know your thoughts, opinions, and more in the comments down below. I'd love to hear from you guys down there. If you guys did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new or you want to stay up to date on all the latest GTA and Red Dead Redemption videos that I'm doing here on my channel. And be sure to ring that notification bell as well. Sometimes YouTube just doesn't work, and if you ring that bell, you'll always be guaranteed to be notified when new videos arrive. But of course, as always, guys, thank you all so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.